friends, this video is about Newton's three laws of motion. But first, let's talk about the man behind these three laws. Sir Isaac Newton. Newton first formally described these laws in his book Principia in the year 1627. He was an English mathematician, astronomer, author, and physicist. He was widely recognized as one of the most influential scientists of all time. Without further ado, let's begin our explanation of how Sir Newton changed our understanding of the universe, by enumerating his three laws of motion. And then we will understand these laws one by one in detail. Newton's first law, also known as the law of inertia, states that every object will remain at rest or in uniform motion in a straight line unless compelled to change its state by the action of an external force. Newton's second law states force is equal to mass times acceleration, which means the acceleration of an object is dependent upon two variables, the net force acting upon the object and the mass of the object. Newton's third law states that for every action force in nature there is an equal and opposite reaction. Let's now understand these laws one by one in detail with some examples. First law of motion says, every object in a state of uniform motion tends to remain in that state of motion unless an external force is applied to it. That means if an object is at rest, it will stay at rest unless a net force acts on it. If an object is in motion, it will stay in motion unless a net force acts on it. For example, the soccer ball, when kicked, keeps going forward until friction, a person, or another object like a goalpost stops it. When a soccer ball is resting non-moving on the ground, it will stay like that until someone kicks it or another force acts upon it. Now let's understand the Newton's second law of motion. F is equals to m times a, which is force equals mass times acceleration. This law describes the relationships between force and acceleration. They are directly proportional. If you increase the force applied to an object, the acceleration of that object increases by the same factor. For example, the more weight the soccer ball has, the slower it goes. The more weight the player has, the slower he can run. Heavier people kick farther than lighter people. Lighter people can run faster than heavier people. More force you apply, more the acceleration you get. That means second law helps in interpreting the amount of energy needed to move an object. The law states that whenever a force acts on a particular object, the object will accelerate with the direction of the force. The law goes on to state that as long as the mass of an object is constant, increasing the force exerted onto it will also increase its acceleration. If you apply same amount on more mass or weight, lesser the acceleration you get. Which means, if the force remains constant, then the increase of the mass of the object will cause acceleration to decrease. This law helps us, calculating the acceleration from a force. We know law say force equals mass times acceleration. You can change this formula around to solve for acceleration by dividing both sides by the mass. So, acceleration equals force divides by mass. Force is directly proportional to the acceleration, meaning that a greater force will lead to a greater acceleration. Mass is inversely proportional to acceleration, meaning that with a greater mass, the acceleration will decrease. Now let's understand the Newton's third law of motion. The third law says, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. A force is a push or a pull that acts upon an object due to its interaction with another object. According to Newton, whenever objects A and B interact, they exert forces upon each other. Also known as action force and reaction force. If you kick the soccer ball, it will kick back at you just as hard. You usually don't realize this because your leg doesn't seem to move, but this is because your leg has more mass, meaning it has more inertia. That is the resistance to movement. When a soccer player kicks the ball, he transfers his momentum to the ball. So, how to identify action and reaction forces? Let us take an example of swimming. Why does a swimmer push the water backward? When we swim, we apply force and push the water backward with the help of our hands. In response to this action, the water pushes us forward with an equal force. Thus, to move forward and swim, the swimmer pushes the water backward. In this case, action force is when swimmer pushes the water in the background directions. And the reaction force is when water exerts a force on the swimmer. So, these were the Newton's three laws of motion. Friends, if you like this video, then please hit the like button. Before ending this video, let us move to Did You Know section. Did you know? The Principia book in which Newton's laws of motion were published is considered one of the most important works in the history of science. Principia is a work in three books by Isaac Newton, first published on 5th July 1687. That's all for now. If you have any questions and queries, please post in the comment section, and also share this video with your friends, so that they can also learn. Have a nice day, folks.